Whether this is, you know, this is the Monoecious plant. So this is on Kasaba Germplasm Center in inside the UMS. Maybe you have never seen that one. So my target is to show you how they are monoecious. So meiosis, meaning is that the male and female flower in the same plant but in different position. So today I want to show you so how these flowers are arranged. So you see, I want to show you, this is one plant. So I'm showing, this one is the branch. You can see this branch is coming here. So this is one branch, huh? So the same plant, so this is another branch. So today I will show you the same plant but male and female flower in different position, sometimes in the same inflorescence can be happened. So here you can see it. I want to show you, this is flower. So this is the flower, you can see. So inside the flower, if this from my one hand, so very difficult to open. So but carefully I want to show you. So this is, you can see, I am removing the petals. So you can see, can you see, this is stigma. You can see, this is the stigma. There is no anther here. You can see there is no anther here, only stigma. So this is the whitish color. This is stigma, you can see clearly. So this is stigma. So this is the female flower. So in female, this mostly all here. All flower is here, the female. See another one female. So after going to laboratory, I will show you very clearly. So this is one branch. This is one branch from the same plant. You can see so many fruits here, already set. The so many fruits. You can see this is the new inflorescence. So this is one branch. Many flower on the fruits here. So in the side by side, here I am to show you another branch. You can see this inflorescence. So the same plant, you can see, this is the same plant but in different branch. So I am trying to bring out this branch. You can see, so this is another branch. So from here you can see the some of the flowers here. So I want to show you the inside of the flower. So here you can see the same plant but different, huh? So you can see here, you can see, so there are so many, if you can see clearly, is it possible to see? If you can, you can see so many anther. So that means the simply there another flower. So inside have the yellowish color with the anther. So I have already plucked off this, so you can see. So you can see that one. Can you see clearly? So there are so many anther here, yellow color. So I'm sorry, I cannot show properly. So yellowish color, you can see. So I'm trying to make it bigger. So you can see so many. So you can see here all are anther. You can see. So if you can see, this one is anther. You can see, now you can clearly see. So there's so many yellowish color. So all these are. There's so many anther. So after going to laboratory, I will show you and count how they are. So many is, I want to show you this one plant, from single plant, one branch bearing the female flower and another branch is bearing the male flower. So meaning is that they are monoecious. So if you want to go for the hybridization, so after going to lab, I will show you how we can do that. Okay, from the continuation of the previous video, so you can see I have opened up a female flower. You can see this is the stigma. this white color. So you can see properly, this is the three-lobed stigma, the female flower from one branch, single branch. So I am showing the different parts, then I will show you the details. So you can see this is the female flower with the 5 petals. So of all female or male, everyone, they have 5 petals. So this is stigma and the petals, you can see 5 petals, and this you can see 10 anthers. So 10 anthers, yellowish colors. So this all yellow, that means they are wearing the pollen. So still I have the pollen, so I can show, because it's difficult to show in this video. So if you touch the anther, we can see so many pollen here. So 10, total 10 anthers, one three-lobed stigma, and all the flowers have 5 petals. So this is the top one, you can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is petals, and this is the fruits, huh? This is the fruits. So I want to show you again. So this is one flower. So this is the female, you can see this is the female flower with 3-lobed stigma. You can see this one is a stigma. And so there are many other inflorescence, immature inflorescence. There are so many fruits here. So this branch containing the female flower. So sometimes the same branch, so see, they have 3 branches, you can see. So they have 3 branches. So sometimes the same branch, the opposite or on branch is bearing the female, another branch is bearing the male. Even sometimes the same inflorescence, sometimes the same inflorescence, they also can carry male and female at the same flower, the same inflorescence. So very interesting. So actually sometimes it can be happened, eh? Very mysterious. So I want to show you here another one. This one is bearing the male flower. So you can see the male flower. I want to break out this branch, it will be easier to show you. So you can see here, so you can see this, I'm opening the flower, you can see I'm trying to open. These are all petals. So inside the petals, the yellowish, you can see these all are stigma. There are 10 anthers, sorry, this is 10 female, 10 anthers. So inside they have 10 anther. So that means but interestingly, you can see you have another fruit. So this is the male flower, but they have another fruit. So meaning is that in the same inflorescence, this is on inflorescence or branch of inflorescence. So this one is male, but this one is female. So female, that means they have produced the fruits. So it can be happened. Huh? So as I saw, the same branch, sometimes some flowers become male, some flower become female. So for this, in the same branch, they can bear the male and female fruits, all female flower all together. But usually we can see the part, this one is rare case, but usually side by side, one branch they bear male, another branch they bear female. So you can see they have all are anther here, huh? So this yellowish color, all are anther. So by this way, as the male flower, they can be when today is starting male, so maybe after 1 week or 2 weeks they start the female. So meaning is that some branch they ending the flower, so another branch they starting flower. So by this way they can help in pollination. So and so for this they can bear the fruits. So this is the male, you can see. This is the another, I have another branch. So this one also bearing the male and female all together in the same branch. Because male, that means they are 100% male, there is no female there. So but it can be a question, so how in that case the same branch, you can see here this one, so this one also the same case, there is this one is male flower, you can see. And to show you, and by opening by hand, one hand, so you can see this is male. So this is male flower, but in the same inflorescence already they have another two fruits. So another two fruits, you can see the same. So the top flower is the female, male, and the below flower was female. So for this, they have produced the fruits also. So by this way, we can ensure that they are male and female. So more clearance. So the final clearance, I am trying to show you again. This is the male flower. I have removed the all petals. So the interestingly, you can see that this one is male, but already they have the fruits. So that means the same inflorescence, they've also produced the female flower as well. So this is the male. So this another one I am trying to show you. This one is the female. You can see this is the female. So this one is stigma with the 5 petals. This is the male. This is the male flower. Sorry, female flower. This is the female flower with a stigma. And here also have some fruits in the same inflorescence. So, and this is, so altogether, if you want to show you, so this is, you can see, this is the male and female. So, regarding the, so if you want to, if so, for the pollination or the hybridization, what we will have to do? Okay, now I want to discuss about the pollination and hybridization of cassava. So this is, we already know the male and female flower, they are different, that means they are monoecious. So for the hybridization, we no need any musculation because the male and female totally different. So this is the female flower, and the another one is, this one is the male flower. So for hybridization, so before opening blooming, so we have to bag the female flower to protect from the any types of undesired hybridization. So if you keep it open, so then the insect or anyhow they will receive the pollen, so our target will be dismissed. So for that, so suppose today if we can detect this flower may be open tomorrow, so today you have to bag the female flower, no need the male. So this male flower you have to bag today before opening. You have to careful that, you have to very carefully understand that before blooming, that means before opening the flower, you have to bag that one. Then tomorrow, usually the cassava, they usually open around noon, 12 after 12 or 11 to 12 or until maybe the 4 or 5, we can get them very easily. So next noon, when we can see the, after opening the bag, if we see the male female flower already bloom, so then we have to collect the male, that means the anther, from the desired parent. So hybridization, that means you have to have two different parent with the desired characteristics, targeted characteristics, what you want to transfer or what you are expecting a new variety. So based on that, you have to select two variety, one is male, one is female. So that means the what type of characteristic you want to transfer, this one you have to consider as a male, and the female, they will receive the characteristics and they will care in the, that means the expression is from the root, because the our output, the, our yield is the root. So this one is the male. So but when next noon, when the female flower is open, so you have to collect the male flower and you have to do the pollination and you have to bag again, because they are so far, if I'm not mistaken, so maybe I have forgotten, the female flower, they are active for 3 days. So that means they are 3 days they can receive the pollen. So for this, you have to, after pollination, you have to bag. So that means the, we have to bag the female flower after pollination. This is in white color, so very easy. So when you the pollen is yellow color, so when the you can toss the pollen over the stigma, you can see whether they have any pollen or not. So easily we can see the yellow color and white color. So we can see they are successfully pollinated. And this is the about the hybridization. But if you want to maintain the parental line, that means we have collected the from the same parent, same plant, this flower. So what you have to do, you also have to do the bagging, but you have to collect the pollen from the same flower. Same flower, the pollen, that means the anther, the same male flower from the same plant,
then you have to just do the pollination. That we are not expecting any variation, just to maintain the parental line. And so by this way, this is indirectly, this is also hybridization, but from the same plant, the same parent, so they are pollination, and the target is maintaining of the parental line. So it can be for the male or can be for the female. So that is which one you are selecting. So based on that, you have to targeted plant. So by this way, we can pollinate and we can maintain the parental line. And if you want to the hybridization, we have to choose two different parent based on the different characteristics. So for the cassava, this output, our yield is the root. So if we, our target is the, we want to produce so many root, more than 8. So we have to select out two types of variety, those who have the huge number of roots, or maybe bigger size of root, or maybe wrong long root, or maybe the disease resistant, the rot resistance, or maybe the other different types of disease and pest resistance. So based on that, you have to select two parent and you have to go for the hybridization. By this way, you can improve or the produce new variety. So this is all about the cassava pollination, cassava hybridization, maintenance of parental line, and as well as to quality increase or develop new types of variety.